In this series of tutorials, we are learning AutoCAD 2020 from start to finish. In the previous set of tutorials, we have learned AutoCAD 2D and 3D modeling in detail. Now, in this tutorial, we will learn isometric concept in detail. New videos on all CAD softwares are released every alternate Monday. To get notification of new video, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. Let's start. To switch to isometric mode, click here on ISO draft. Then your cursor will become inclined like this. And if you don't want to see this grid, then click here on grid mode. So it will turn it off. I will keep this grid mode on. Then at first we will create one horizontal plate in isometric. For that, click here on line, then specify first point. Then in isometric you always have to keep ortho mode on. Click here on ortho mode and turn it on. Then take your cursor on this side. So here you can see that line is automatically created in 150 degree. Then specify your length of 1000, press enter. Take your cursor above and specify height of 250, enter. Then take your cursor on this side. We want to create this line of the same length as per this line. So take your cursor below on this endpoint. Don't click there and take it away. So it will track that point. Click and click on this endpoint. Now I have created this rectangle on left plane. Now I want to create one more rectangle on the right plane. But if you take your cursor on this side, line is not going on this side because we are right now on left plane. To change plane, you will have to click on this arrow near isodraft. And from here you can choose your desired plane. So I want to work on right plane. So click on isoplane right. So here now this cursor is going on this side. You can also change your isoplane by pressing F5 on keyboard. If you press F5, it will change the plane. Now here our plane is isoplane left. Again if I click on F5, now isoplane is top. And again F5, then isoplane is right. So by pressing F5 also, you can change your isoplane. Then take your cursor on this side, specify length of 1500, enter. Then I want to track length from this point. So take your cursor on this point and take it away. Now here it is tracking properly. But if at your end, it fails to track, then you will have to make one setting. For that, right click here on polar tracking, click on tracking settings. So you will have to specify here increment angle of 30 and tick here track using all polar angle setting, then only it will track all the angles in the increment of 30 degree. And if it is on track orthogonally only, then it will not track. So I will tick here, click on OK, then click and click, press enter to stop line command. Then you can repeat last command by pressing enter. So to repeat line command, press enter, then click here on this endpoint, then take your cursor to this endpoint and track it. And click and click, press enter. So here this horizontal plate is created. Then in isometric, offset command is not useful. In the place of offset, you will have to use copy command. Suppose I want to create one parallel line to this line at some distance, then you will have to use copy command. Click on copy, select this object, enter. Specify base point, take your cursor on this side and specify your distance. Suppose I want 700, enter. So here a parallel line is created at a distance of 700. Same way, copy command is still running. If you want to create further copy, you can specify your distance. Suppose I want at a distance of 1000, enter, and to come out, press escape. So in this way, to create parallel lines, you will have to use copy commands. Then to create circle, take your cursor to ellipse and click on this arrow and click on axis end. Then click on isocircle. Suppose I want to create circle at the center of this plate. So take your cursor on this midpoint, don't click there, and take your cursor at this midpoint. So it will mark it for tracking and take it in the center. So here it has located the center point of this plate, click there and take your cursor away. Now this circle is created on the right plane. So to change plane, click here on this arrow. Now I want to create this circle on top plane. So click here on isoplane top and specify radius. Suppose I will click on this midpoint. So it will take that radius automatically. Then I want to create one cylinder here. For that you will have to copy this circle. Click on copy. Select this circle, press enter, specify base point. Then my cursor is going horizontally. So I want to go on the upper side. For that you will have to change your plane. Click here on this arrow and I will choose this right plane. And take your cursor above and specify height. Suppose height is 500, enter and enter. Then I will have to create here lines. For that click here on line, then specify first point at this quadrant point, click, and second point will be this quadrant point, click, enter, enter, then click on this quadrant point and this quadrant point, enter. Then to remove internal objects, type TR for trim, press enter, cutting edges will be these lines, then press enter and remove these objects, press enter. So here this cylinder is created. Then I don't want these lines, I will remove them, type E, enter, and select these lines, press enter. Next I want to give dimensions to this object. For that click here on dimension, then take your cursor on this line and click. Now here it is creating horizontal or vertical dimension, but I don't want vertical or horizontal, but I want aligned dimension. So to create aligned dimension, you will have to turn off this ortho mode. So click here on ortho mode, then take your cursor on this side and click. Same way I will create for this line, click, click on this line. Now here it is not catching that line, so just zoom there and click on this line and take your cursor away and click, press escape. Now dimensions are not visible. To make them visible, type D for dimension style, press enter, click on modify, click on fit, and from here you will have to change use overall scale of. Suppose I will make it 25. Okay, close. Now dimensions are properly visible, but these dimensions are going down. I want to align this dimension with this line. So for that click here on annotate, click on dimensions and click on oblique, then select this dimension, press enter. Now here you will have to specify obliquing angle. Now in isometric, these lines are at 30 degree, and as these three lines are parallel, that means all these three lines are at 30 degree. Then these three lines are at 90 degree and these three lines are at 150 degree. So we want to align this extension line with this line. So the angle of this line is 150 degree. So here you will have to specify 150, enter. So here this line got aligned with this line. Same way to align this dimension, click here on dimension, click on oblique, then select this dimension. Now angle for this dimension and this dimension will be same. So you can also select multiple dimension which are in same direction, then press enter. So this extension line will match with this line. Now angle of this line is 30 degree, so specify here 30, press enter. So here these dimensions got aligned. Then to specify radius of this circle, you will have to use multi-leader. Click here on multi-leader, then specify leader arrowhead location. So I will specify here, then take your cursor away and click. Then type their radius R500 and click outside. Then to make them visible properly, click here on multi-leader style manager. Click on modify, click on leader structure and specify scale here. Suppose scale is also 25. Okay, close. Here that radius is visible. But if you see, it is looking larger as compared to dimensions. It is because text height specified in leader is more. So to reduce that text height, click here on multi-leader style manager, click on modify, click on content and reduce this text height to 2.5, because in ISO text height is 2.5. click on OK, click on close. Now here both the text size are matching. Then this text is not aligned like this. It is visible as it is coming out. So to align this text, we will have to create some textiles. To create textiles, click here on textile. Now here we will have to align this text in 30 degree angle and this text in minus 30 degree. So click on new. I will name this textile as 30. Okay. Then specify here oblique angle of 30. Apply. Then again click on new. Name it as minus 30. Okay. Oblique angle as minus 30. Apply. Then click on close. Click on yes. Then to apply selected textiles to these dimensions, click here on dimension style. Then we will keep this ISO 25 as it is and we will create new dimension style. Click on new, name it as 30, continue, click on text and from here choose 30 textile. Click on OK. Again click on new, name it as minus 30, continue, then select here minus 30, okay, close. Then select this dimension, click here and make it minus 30. So here it got horizontal perfectly. Press escape, select this dimension, click here and make it 30. Escape, same way this one, click here and here minus 30. So by taking your cursor on that particular dimension style, it is showing you the preview. So click, press escape. So here this dimension has been placed perfectly. So that's all for now. In the next tutorial, we will solve one example based on what we learn in this tutorial. If you learned something from this video, then please like and share this video. And to receive notification for new videos every alternate Monday, subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.